like, look for the untraditional, look for the people that are bucking the trend. That's where the opportunity is. Once everybody's talking about a particular thing, all the opportunity is gone. You got to look for the thing that people aren't talking about.
Real Estate Investing Profits presents Profit Masters with your host, world-renowned real estate coach and investor, Corey Boatwright. Now, strap in and get ready to learn elite wealth-building investment strategies taught by six- and seven-figure house flipping masters as they reveal their best real estate investing profit secrets to you right now.
What is going on, my potted people? My name is Corey Boatwright. I am your host of Real Estate Investing Profit Masters and the founder of Real Estate Investing Profits. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're doing fantastic, phenomenal. I am bringing you another interview, incredible value, with Scott Smith from Royal Legal Solutions. Now, Scott is kind of your one-stop shop if you're a real estate investor looking for a legal solution. He does not handle the securities, which is the Series 7, but he does work with partner attorneys on that if you have questions about it. So he's going to handle anything for entity structuring, things like that. He's going to handle working with title companies. He's going to handle probate. He's going to handle all kinds of issues that come up with real estate investing, and there are many of them, as you know. You are going to love this episode. It's going to give you a lot of value, and you're going to have really a solution now if you're looking for some legal remedy. So make sure you take good notes. Next question. Have you downloaded your Ultimate Real Estate Investing Quick Start Guide? Have you? If not, simply text the word PROFIT to 38470, 38470, and it'll be automatically downloaded to your device. If you're interested in real estate investing coaching, right now is the time to get plugged in. We are always looking at the right kind of candidate. We don't want to work with you if you don't want to work with us. We want to see if we're a good fit. The way we do that is we ask you a few questions. Simple little website. Go to Corey's Coaching, C-O-R-Y-S, coaching.com. Ask a couple of questions and see if we're a good fit. It'd be a great time for you to learn about real estate wholesaling, which is what we focus on and do a little over 100 a year. And we opened up a national division, so we are expanding in that regard. So I hope you enjoy this episode. It is going to give you a lot of value, and I'll see you on the next one. Here is Mr. Scott Smith from Royal Legal Solutions. Scott, how are you doing, my man?
Corey, I'm doing fantastic, brother. How are you doing?
I am doing phenomenal. I'm getting ready for Thanksgiving, and we got the turkey ready and family coming in. How about you?
Oh, man. Nothing like a belly full of turkey and a nap. I tell you, I'm looking forward to it.
The tryptophan, right?
Yeah, it'll get you. Gets me every time. I usually pass out by about the third quarter of the football game.
Right. Well, I appreciate you taking the time to be on here, and I'm excited about getting to know you a little bit more. You know, you and I are just really beginning to meet each other. I know that you have got a pretty successful legal practice, and out of Austin, is that where you're headquartered?
Yeah, we're out of Austin, Texas. So we have a staff of about 30 people, a number of attorneys, paralegals. We have a core team that's here in Austin. But I was able to recruit great talent from all over the country. So we have a decentralized team that also helps everywhere. So
well, that's great. And you focus a lot on asset protection. We'll get into that. I know you do some other things as well. And you were talking just before we got on here about series LLCs and some really cool strategies on really structure for companies. But I want to get into who is your ideal client?
So my ideal client is the only niche that I focus in at Royal Legal is for real estate investors. So I'm a real estate investor myself. I have been for over 6 years now. And what I did was had to solve all of these problems and becoming a real estate investor for myself. And then other people hounded me to start helping them. So I kind of accidentally started this law firm that's just dedicated to real estate investors all over the country in every asset class. So Those, if you're a real estate investor, like, I'm your guy. There's not going to be anybody that's going to know more about the problems you run into and how to solve them than me, because this is all I do.
Now, also, just to be specific, you're not a Series 7, are you, on the security side?
No, I don't do the securities side of when you have to do like PPMs and doing that level of investing. We have partner attorneys that we work with other firms on how does that work in the broader context. But you should think of like my company as one of very unique one-stop shops for real estate investors, because we take care of everything from the entity structuring to estate planning to connections with title companies, 1031 exchange companies, coaches. We have our own coaching programs, invitation to our podcasts. Like, so that one stop to say like, hey, if I wanted one point of contact to solve all of my problems for me, so I only have to focus on finding the next great deal. That's what I've created at Royal Eagle.
I love it. Okay. And what made you want to get involved with real estate investing? Because I know you're not just doing single family. You're also doing, you have some commercial now. Maybe do you have some apartments as well, or do you stay more in single family, more leaning toward multifamily? What made you want to get involved with real estate investing?
Yeah, so my current holdings are single family, multifamily, notes, and commercial. You know, okay. I also help people that are doing auction buying and all kinds of other stuff, right, that comes into the types of business strategies. As we find at the end of the day, right, there's nobody better than the investor that's going to know the way to make money out of the deal, right? But then everything besides that is a system and a process that needs to be solved by operational people that are like me. Like, hey, we run the operations background to your business so you can focus on your creatives, which is finding that next great deal, right? I actually got into real estate investing when I was in law school. I bought a transmission and auto repair shop and the business and the building. I rehabbed the building during law school and built the business up and then flipped it to be the only graduate from Albany Law School to graduate without debt, right?
That's awesome, Scott. Yeah. I love it. That's killer.
Yeah. But that's where it caught me. And that's where I fell in love with real estate, because I was like, holy smokes, man, I made more money out of doing these couple little things than all the other attorneys that I knew about. But I was really dedicated from coming out of law school that I really wanted to be a litigator. You know, so I was working for the district attorney's office. I was doing trials there. I was working inside of the appellate courts. And then after that, I went to private practice to be able to sue insurance companies, because come to find out insurance companies are great at collecting premiums and not so good at paying out coverage, especially when it gets expensive. So we were suing the pants off of those guys. And all the while, I'm collecting more and more assets with my real estate. And I was like, okay, well, I actually am making more money doing real estate investing part-time than with this crazy stressful law job. So I just left the law piece, focused on real estate investing full-time. Ran into these problems with having a scalable real estate business and had to solve those problems and started sharing with other people. And that's kind of how Royal Eagle started, was almost by accident, by me sharing with other people the problems I had to solve for myself while I was growing my real estate business and now as I continue to grow it.
You know, it's interesting too. You said you never lost a case.
I've never lost a case, no.
Yeah. So that's great, man. I bet you had some great stories, you know, suing these insurance companies. Yeah. These premiums that we pay, it's absurd, you know, sometimes. And then when it's time to actually pay out and you need it, you know, here in Oklahoma, you get hailstorms or, you know, tornadoes or God forbid, even earthquakes here. It's like, it's, you know, so hard to be able to get any of that money paid back out. And then there's so many I's dotted, T's crossed, red tape, you know, that has to have every specific little thing in order to get that money back. I bet you have a lot of stories.
Well, it gets really wild, Corey, because it's a lot of people have a couple of misconceptions, I think, about lawsuits, right? So there's a lot of myths out there about like what actually happens with the law. The first thing that usually happens is people think like if you're a good and honest person that you won't ever get sued. So right. They'll say, hey, all I need is an umbrella insurance policy. Right. And I'm good to go, right? Because I'm never going to get sued because I'm a good and honest person. When the fact is, honest people get sued all the time. The second thing that people come up with is say, like, my insurance company are good people. They're going to pay me out. It's like, well, no, insurance companies are profit-seeking corporations. They watch a bottom line into it, right? And I used to sue them when they didn't pay out. So, like, I have the firsthand knowledge of, like, how that actually works. The third major thing that people don't really understand about lawsuits is that it's a business. Litigation is a business just like any other business, but it's a business that's built on gambling. And how that works is this, is that when somebody comes into your door as an attorney with a potential claim, right? You evaluate the strengths of that claim, and that tells you what your probability of success in the lawsuit is going to be. You also look at for the damages. So attorneys are kind of sadistic people in a lot of ways, because the worst thing that ever happened to your client means the more money you're going to make, sure, right? Yeah. And then the last thing you look for is how can you collect if you win? So you have high damages, they have a good claim underneath the facts and the law. And then in the best case scenario, there's a ton of money there at the end of the rainbow to be able to collect. So what that's how it works on the attack side. That's called the plaintiff side. How it works on the defense side is that you have to be able to undermine one of those three things. So if you want to avoid lawsuits, you can't really control the facts. You can't really control the law, right? Mm-hmm. What you can control is their ability to collect. And that's how you're able to attack the business of lawsuits to ensure that you're never sued. And if you are sued, you're able to get out of it with little to nothing loss. It's because if you think about lawsuits as a business, we can know how that attorney is going to think and approach it and make it where it's a bad business decision for him to ever go after you.
That makes a lot of sense. I can tell that you have really thought through all these things and have gone through, I think, some wars. In order to have some success on the end of it. Sure. What was one of your biggest influences for investing?
Yeah, so my biggest influence in investing was really just my first experience of actually going through law school and actually just buying the building. And part of that was mainly because I was just so excited about it. I read Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and for better or worse, right, I was armed with what I thought was tons of knowledge. And I was like, oh, I know real estate investing, right? I've read two books on this. Here's a great opportunity to buy a building for the back taxes, essentially, that are on it. How can I lose? And it has a business in it. And I mean, business doesn't seem that hard. You get people to come in, you fix their stuff and ship it out the back door. I had no idea what I was actually buckling up for. And if I would have known, I probably wouldn't have done it, right? But me being me, right, I dive headfirst into stuff and then I just learn as much as I possibly can while I'm actually doing
it. I'm the same way, man. Yeah.
Yeah. And then when you learn this way, what happens is it's extremely painful, but you make rapid progress, right, into what it's going to be. And one of the things that really helped me along the way is that I was always really proactive and humble about reaching out to people that knew more than me. And to always hit them up, both on the business side and the real estate side. So I couldn't really point to like one particular thing, but definitely I would say the biggest influence for me in just getting going, it was definitely Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and whatever his board game is. What is that called? The Cash Flow
101 or Cash Flow.
Cash Flow Quadrant.
I think it's just called Cash Flow. Yeah.
Yeah. The Cash Flow game or whatever.
Right.
Was eye-opening for me about playing a board game, which sounds kind of dumb, but like I was so novice, even being a law student, about how basic finances worked, and come to find out that that's not unnormal. I mean, doctors, attorneys, high-level professionals, really intelligent people, they're really geniuses at their one niche, but they don't understand the basics of how to create time freedom, financial freedom, create a life that's actually fulfilling for you as an individual. And all of those things are actually possible through real estate as a vehicle to that ultimate goal, in my experience.
It's so true. I get a chance to work with a really amazing individual named David Phelps. He's actually out of Texas as well. He has a group called Freedom Founders, just an amazing group. And usually it's mostly dentists. They have practices they want to sell, or they're still running them, or chiropractors or practices. And David came from a place where he had a successful dental practice and sold it. But then also was investing in real estate and figured out a way to free himself from the chair was by having the passive income coming in from the real estate. And this really made a big difference in his life. And so now he teaches this to his students in order to get free. They can invest in real estate and have this passive income. And it's amazing because he works with some of the smartest, brightest and intellectual folks, academia, you know, to the hilt. And yet some of those pieces of time freedom and, oh, wait, if I don't work, can I still get a paycheck? How's that work? How's that look? Oh, wait, what's the risk factor and all these other things that you're having to compare and think about. And just because you have a really high IQ doesn't mean you have much of an EQ, and certainly doesn't mean you have much of the road of hard knocks or street knowledge. And those things really can make a big difference, especially whenever you are looking at different investments that can pay you quite handsomely. I mean, it doesn't make a lot of sense to most folks that haven't been investing to buy something whenever it's non-performing. Why would you do that? You know what? You want to buy something when it's performing? Well, because most of the time you don't make a lot of your money whenever you buy something at the top of the heap. You make it, you know, capitalism, make it where you buy low and sell high. And so just some of these basic principles, you would think that would be something that most people would know. They don't know. And it's not a surprise really that they don't.
A surprise, right? I mean, like, 'cause it's not something that nobody teaches you in school, and you have to seek it out on your own, right? To go with it. And part of my journey with that has always been seeking out professionals that have made money in the same way I've made money. 'Cause just like an attorney or a CPA or any other professional that's out there, they'll understand their niche, but they won't understand how it necessarily applies to a particular business model. And I think that's what's so ingenious about like what your friends invented, right? To be like, hey, I really understand how dentists think about business and how they think about something like real estate, right? And this is where I've typically always found that it's like people that are like that tend to do really, really well because they're able to attract the like-minded people with them to be able to lead them into the new direction. And I look for that I always try to do the same thing. Who's out there that's like me, that has really niche expertise, that's made money the same way I have? And if I can find those three things in somebody, boom, they're part of my inner circle and network, because I'm like, man, that person is going to be able to help me if they've walked a road I haven't walked before, because I'm going to make the same mistakes they did. And I know that I'm going to make the same mistakes they did unless I learn from them.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. We talked about this before, which is kind of like your breaking point. You're like, hey, working as an attorney, I could realize I make more money as a real estate investor. So I'd say that's kind of where we talk about what your breaking point kind of was, where you said, I need to put more emphasis on this real estate thing. What is what we call your profit master investing strategy on this show, which is really something that's impacted the bottom line the most, maybe with the clients you work with or in your own business? What's one of the best strategies that you can share right now as one that's really done well for profits for you?
Yeah, so one of the greatest things that I've run across is actually just using a BRRRR type strategy, where buying properties and then hooking up with a really good contractor to be able to improve on those properties, refinance all of my cash, and then go to the next one. That's how it really, using that strategy is the number one way I've been able to scale.
Can you explain the BRRRR? I know it's an acronym, but some people that may not know what that is, can you explain it?
Yeah, so what it is, you buy a dumper, right? You push a bunch of money into that dumper, and you raise the value of that dumper. And then you go to the bank and you say, hey, bank, I want you to refinance out 80, 90% of this dumper. And the refinance rate out of that dumper gets you all your cash back that you pushed into that property, plus some money, and you still own the asset. And hopefully the asset still cash flows after you have it rented in an ideal scenario, right? And then that lets you still have that asset. You still have all of your cash back. Maybe you have some extra cash, right? That asset's cash flowing. Then you go buy your next property. Where dudes are killing it right now, Corey, is in the commercial space. I work with a guy right now that's buying $2 million toys, like old Toys R Us buildings. He's getting them chopped up and then being able to get them refinanced at a $7 million rate by being able to get into it. It's absolutely disgusting. So like whenever you're able to get into that place where you have more cash and you're having, and you need that kind of level of assets, that's one of the things that we've quarterbacked at Royal Legal, is our own network of members that are clients, and that we're offering those types of connections selectively, right? Because guys like that, right? They're not out there like trying to spread the word, right? About here's all the amazing money that we're doing and let me show you how to do it, right?
Right.
But there's definitely people that they still want connections with and that they still want help with. And that's one of the things that I do for all of my members, is like quarterback people together that I think are like a good fit. Now, we do have something that's like open air type discussions, like through the Q&A sessions we'll do when I bring on, you know, A-list celebrity people onto our live shows or onto my own podcast, and then invite the members to it. But there's just a world of opportunity that I find that isn't even being talked about in the public space, and for good reason, because there's really limited supply of what those assets are. And it takes a really specialized knowledge of how to invest $2 million and actually be able to line up all the contracts to be able to convert it into a $7 million property.
Specialized knowledge is what it's all about. You know, that's, at the end of the day, you know, you can have this massive random amounts of knowledge that will serve you in the very minimal amount, maybe in conversations to make you feel cool or answer Jeopardy questions. But, or you can have specialized knowledge that is specific and intentional for investing in multifamily and commercial and notes or whatever it is, and be able to capitalize on that and focus on that and really hone in the craft. And then you can, like you said, you can crush it, you can kill it, because you know things that other people don't know. You are creating a niche, you know, for your investing strategies.
Yeah. I find that to be really true. Like the one tricky part is that I've run across with myself is that the people that have the true specialized knowledge, right? They don't fit into the mainstream, right? So we're like programmed as human beings to see like how many people say something, and then we attribute credibility based upon how many people said it. Like that's part of our tribal nature, right? But the truly advanced, the people that are on the cutting edge of what's the right thing to do, they're always outsiders to it, right? So this is also something that happens with Royal Legal, right? So Royal Legal, I've always built it to always be on the cutting edge of it, right? But that always means I'm always bucking an information trend for what you see of like the common kind of vanilla style of advice that people are getting. And so it always becomes a really interesting piece that you get to, if you ever want to be living in that space, that that you want to be on the cutting edge space, be willing to take a lot of grief for it, and be willing to be able to really know your stuff, to be able to fight for like why this is right. But it's also the most fun place to live into. So I would say for any piece of advice for people out there is like, look for the untraditional, look for the people that are bucking the trend. That's where the opportunity is. Once everybody's talking about a particular thing, all the opportunity is gone. You got to look for the thing that people aren't talking about.
Look for the thing that no one's talking about. Yeah, I agree with that. And I think that you create a cool niche being a litigator, because you're not afraid of controversy, you're not afraid to stand for something. And, you know, that's what it takes, the polarization aspects of conversations and strategies that you work with. You not just go with what everybody else says to go with. I mean, absolutely, 100%. What was one of the biggest challenges, speaking of what that could look like, what is one of the biggest challenges that you faced and how did you get through it?
Yeah. So one of the biggest challenges that I face is actually, you know, developing a system, right? Using series LLCs with anonymity trust to hold companies anonymously. And how do you use land trust in conjunction with that and use that all over the country that's hard to figure out. And it's something that everybody, if you just start reading online and talking to people that don't have the specialized knowledge, they always tell you, you can't do that. And here's all the reasons why you can't do it. But come to find out with a little bit harder work and a little bit more research, you're able to find an opportunity that people haven't capitalized on yet, right? So that was really difficult for me as part of a challenge that came up, as a business builder and an attorney. And how do you communicate that in a way that's going to really make sense for people? And I found a really great way to be able to talk about that with the series LLC structure. The biggest challenges that run into my life right now is always around relationships. It's who are the absolute best people that I can partner with in business and connect people to. So I'm always hungry to find like who are the best people that Corey knows, you know, that are in like XYZ things that I'm looking at, to always be expanding my network. The richest people that I know, those guys that are the $100 to $250 million net worth range, into that, that's all they focus on is who's going to be in the network and who can they partner with. All they're doing is acquiring talent, setting up partnerships with those people and equipping those people with tools for those people to go build something to make them money. That's all they're doing. So I was like, shit, I better start thinking that way myself.
Right. Relationships, you know, make all the difference in the world. You and I were just talking about one of the great mastermind groups that I've been a part of for 10 years, Collective Genius, and how it could be a good fit for you as well. I mean, the group with, when you're part of a group, when you're part of a belonging to something, you know, makes all the difference, because you have people that are, you can have conversations with that did deals similar to the way you did deals last month. They struggled with some of the same things you might've been struggling with. They are looking for new opportunities to grow, like you're looking for new opportunities to grow. it's not completely a foreign subject to them whenever you say, oh man, we crushed you yesterday. We did 50K on a deal. I mean, having a conversation like that to the quote, the average person that's not in your space, right? The average person that's not in your space, it's a lonely place to be an entrepreneur. It's a lonely place to be in those, to be in those conversations. And when you have somebody that has been going through some of those same struggles, have had some of those same successes, you know, the mastermind concept, Think and Grow Rich from Napoleon Hill, is not just a fun book. It is something that was built on the core of what our country's built on, you know, with Henry Ford and you know, Carnegie Steel, and with all these incredible entrepreneurs that were forefront for making the country be what it was. It was started from the concept of a mastermind. And relationships is the core of what the mastermind should be. Relationships is the absolute core. What's a great lesson that you've learned that's helped you get to where you are today?
One of the best lessons that I've ever learned is that it doesn't matter how smart you are. That's a tricky one to wrap my mind around. I don't know about you or maybe the people.
Says the attorney. Yeah. So hire Scott.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
No, I want to hear your thought process.
Yeah. Because I think a lot of times we actually really overestimate intelligence as being a lot more important than it really is in a lot of ways. Right. So the way I would define like intelligence is the ability to be able to assimilate new knowledge and to basically probably do puzzle solving. Right.
I like that.
Can you assimilate new stuff and can you solve puzzles really, really well? Right. Well, that actually doesn't turn out to be what's actually the biggest drivers of success. The biggest drivers of success that I see time and time again are usually people that come to the table with a written plan of what it is that they're going to seek out to do. And gosh darn it, do you got to put that baby in writing or it doesn't work? And I don't know why that's the case, but for some reason, that is how just the world works. Right. That's the way the brain works for some reason. So the second thing that they always do is they have to have the right tools in place, because you can end up with like a ton of energy and you can be pushing really, really hard. But if you don't have the right tools or know the right levers that you got to pull at the right time, then it doesn't matter how much energy you have. And it doesn't matter how smart you are, because you're actually just spewing all that energy out there in the world and nothing actually is going to result from it.
Unless you're trying to roof a house with a screwdriver, you're going to have a hard time.
Exactly. Right. But that same analogy applies to marketing, it applies to sales, it applies to how you're going to create your products, it applies to how you're doing your real estate investing, it applies to how you're working your network, et cetera, right? And the last thing that I saw was what really mattered to you was, did you have like a team or a mentor or a guide? Something in there. You need something that's like a team mentor or guide. Somebody who has walked the path before that you're seeking to walk that can tell you what's going on. And here's why that's really important. That last one, I think, is probably the most important one of it all, is because every decision that you've made as Corey or just any of the listeners, if you think back at the time you made the decision, you probably thought it was a great idea. And in fact, of the landscape ideas that you had at the time, it was the best idea. And you would have been able to tell me all of the reasons why that was the best idea. So why then do bad decisions happen?
Right.
It's because a lot of our great ideas are bad. That's we just right. don't know they're bad.
That's right. That's right.
So having a team, a mentor, or a guide that comes in, and that's something we have ready built in for Royal Legal Solutions in all three of these categories. But the reason why you have to have that is because the guide tells you you're going to see that great idea and it's not a great idea. Out of the landscape of the 300 ideas you could do, here's the three that are actually workable, right, that have repeated consistent success. And what we're looking for when we're looking for long-term wealth building, creating time freedom and personal fulfillment, is we're not trying to create anything new. What we're trying to find is what's the most repeatable model of success that gets you from where you're at to where you want to go. And there's only usually a few avenues to do that. When you deviate from those avenues, now you're starting to be a pioneer. And pioneers end up with arrows in their backs. You don't want to be a pioneer. You want to follow a proven, consistent model with people that have made money the same way you do, and that can show you how you can do it as well.
That's great. That's great, man. A lot of great nuggets in there. I hope you're listening to what Scott is saying there. We're going to have all this in the show notes just in case you missed some of it. But those are some great concepts, and I couldn't agree more with with them as well. So if you had to start over, Scott, what are some things you would change? What are some advice for some new folks that might be coming into the space right now? What are some things you tell them?
I would have worked a lot less and networked a lot more into it. Okay. Yeah. I feel like a lot of people are out there trying to hustle super hard to make money, right? Mm. By like banging stuff around. And the reality of the situation is that if you're a reasonably intelligent person and you can talk to people reasonably well and you connect with them, you have like a decent EQ, decent IQ, neither one of those have to be amazing. You can start to find out what people's problems are and who they need to talk to. So part of what we have with Royal Legal is we have kind of like how billionaires have like a family office. We have the same type of concept that we do with for all of our investors, where we quarterback in all of the major providers that they need, from title companies to 1031 exchanges, you know, everything from start to finish that you need as a real estate investor. And we combine them with a dedicated advisor to just help them navigate who are the relationships that I have built for myself and that I share with all of the investors. Where does that come to play with just starting over again? Is because you can make a great living just by finding out what problems people have and talking to them and ask them, hey, what's the roadblocks to your success right now that you're experiencing? And then just pairing them with somebody else that said, hey, I help people that have that roadblock. Sure. And then people will pay you just for your network of being able to connect people together. And in fact, they're happy to pay you sometimes thousands, tens of thousands, or hundreds of thousands of dollars if you have that. And the reason why that's such an amazing way to start is because you're accumulating knowledge first and you're finding out how problems really get solved. Absolutely. And the pathway to wealth is built on problem solving. So the more that you just live in that level of I'm just solving problems for people all day long, you're building your own repertoire of it. And eventually you're going to get to the point where it's like, hey, I actually have all the network. I have all the knowledge. If you gave me $100,000, I could turn it into $1 million this year because I've already walked that path a bunch of times. And if you have that level of confidence where you could take $100,000 from your mother and be like, no, I can turn it into $1 million this next year. Now you're ready to go kill it and whatever you're going to go do.
Yeah, that's great, man. What's one of your favorite motivational or business quotes? Do you have one?
Oh, yeah. I love it from Arnold. Arnold Schwarzenegger, man. I just read it the other day, actually. And I have it. It's actually going to be published as one of my favorite quotes here on Entrepreneurship Magazine, coming out here in the next month or so.
Great.
And what it is that it's like, it's that anybody can be pitied. You have to be special for people to be jealous of you.
That's true. I mean, yeah. once you absolutely take a stand for something, right? It all comes down to setting yourself apart. How are you setting yourself apart? And it certainly isn't going to be doing what everybody else does, like you said.
Yeah. And maybe it's a good thing that people don't like you, you know, or that they're angry with you or that they're upset. Because honestly, like a lot of times, if you look and you just scratch at the surface of this anger, right, of the jealousy, what you're really finding out is that it's people's own pain, right? It's their own fear. It's their own pain that they're reacting to. Yes. And they project that as anger and jealousy onto other people.
Yes.
Because for a number of different reasons, right, that it comes up into it. So you might even take it like a step further, right, and say like you're probably not living as big of a life as you could if people aren't jealous of you, if you don't have people that are upset with you.
You don't have a few haters, right? Another simple way would be if you don't have a few haters, you're probably not pushing hard enough.
Yeah, you're not pushing hard enough. You're not pushing big enough. Go bigger until people start to not like you.
I'm going to put some of these quotes down here, but certainly that one with Arnold. What books do you recommend, or the least, maybe one of them that has changed your life?
There's a book called Emotional Intelligence. I don't remember who wrote it.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah. It's great. Yep.
That book is amazing at being able to just jumpstart your EQ. For what things that you would need to know for that. So that's off the beaten path, a little bit. There's also a great book that's called Tribe of Millionaires. That was recently written by like Pat Hyben and David Osborne and a couple of those guys. And it tells the journey of somebody and finding like their own tribe along their own journey of wealth and like the importance of having your own tribe to be able to get to the next level you want to. Right.
Yeah. I took that test from David too. I know David from talking with him a couple of times and has a bunch of Keller Williams offices and there's also a mastermind group that he has that do you remember the name of his mastermind group?
I think it's called GoBundance.
GoBundance, that's right.
Yeah.
One of our other members, Saul's in that group. He says some great things about it. But so having a tribe, like you said, having a people that are, you know, like and trust, right? They have similarities, so you can build leverage and have great relationships, strong relationships. Again, going back to relationships as the key kind of component there makes all the difference in the world. So that's cool. Remember they took a test, but I didn't know it was called Tribe of Millionaire. I thought the test was something like that.
Well, it's their book that David released recently. David's here in Austin too. They have they released that book, like the Tribe of Millionaires, to kind of tell like an allegorical story. I think of like how they started, like all of those old dogs started way back in the day when you could barely get a hold of anybody. There was no internet. There was no anything. Right. So you like literally email each other and call each other to hold accountability. I mean, I can't even imagine how difficult it was to maintain relationships with people and have that kind of peace, and how much easier it is for us now. If you want it, you know, that's one of the crazy things about like in today's society, right? The access to information is higher than it's ever been, but our ability to connect to each other is lower than it's ever been. Right. So there's some type of asymmetry that's happening here that becomes so important to be involved inside of a group. Right. So whether that's like your group, Corey, or, you know, Collective Genius or Royal Legal or GoBundance or whatever it is, I would stand for the theory anyway, that it doesn't matter initially which group you join, just join a group with people that have the things that you want, right? At some level, that's going to get you to that next step forward. If you're waiting for things to be perfect, what you're really doing is saying, I'm never going to take action. And you're almost always better at just making a decision and going forward with the general direction, learning what that's like, seeing, getting some evidence of the things that you like and you don't like, and then being able to make another choice, because you're not engaged to anything. I mean, even marriage isn't permanent, right? I mean, anything in this life you can change if you want to.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Writing down some good notes here. What's one of your favorite mobile apps do you use in your business every day?
The most impactful app I've ever used is super simple. It's called Habitable.
Habitable?
Habitable, like B-U-L-L.
Oh, okay.
And they have a ton of these. They have a ton of these habit apps, right?
Yeah.
And the reason why that's such an amazing app for me is not because it's like my HubSpot app that can do all these whiz bang things or anything like that, right?
Right.
I focus. What led to the success of Royal Legal and being able to use like the series LLC structures that we use, and figuring out how do you actually do that in a way that works and that's defensible. And something actually that I tell all my clients, that if you ever get sued, me and my litigation team in-house represent you for free once you're a member. That's something no other attorney or law firm could or would do ever. That's how strong I believe in what I do. Wow, and the reason why this becomes so important is how those things actually result is because I would focus on one thing at a time until I understood everything about that piece of the puzzle. And then I would go to the next thing. So it's intense hyper-focus on one thing that allows you to build something that is leaps beyond what everybody else is talking about or even understands really, right? And that's where you can become and saying like you're really on the cutting edge of it. So the reason why that simple app becomes so important for me is because I only build one habit at a time every 60 days, but I have to put it into that habit bowl and I have to tick it off every day. And it doesn't matter what it is. I just have to choose like, what am I going to get in the next 60 days? What's the habit I'm going to build? And I have to tick it off every single day. And I got to tell you how ridiculously difficult it is to do something that takes less than 60 seconds for 60 days in a row and not break it.
Yeah, I'm looking at it right now on the screen, showing everybody on the screen. It looks like it's either works with Android or with the iOS, and you create different habits and you can show accountability from your streaks on your percentage of successful days that you did set habit.
That's it. And in here, they let you set like, I don't know, six habits. You can set tons of habits, right? Yes. What I got to tell you though, is try one.
Right.
Like try one habit and not break it for 60 days and just try that. And try to keep it to something that only does 60 seconds to be able to complete that habit, because it's such a short amount of time. You can't actually justify the excuse of not being able to keep the habit besides the fact that you just suck at keeping habits.
I'm going to write this down. I love this thing. I'm a big tech guy, so I have not heard of Habit Bool. So I'm going to.
You can set it with the notifications too, so it even reminds you. Like it blows up, you see the number, and you're like, ah, shit. All right, 60 seconds. I'm going to brush my teeth and do air squats, you know, or whatever it's going to be for your 60 seconds.
Right. I love it, man. That's great. That's a great app. I'm excited actually to check it out. I like the UI on it. I like how it's, you can see the percentages. Yeah, it's pretty slick. Okay. So do you get 8 hours of sleep at night?
I sleep as much as I need to. Into it. Yeah. So it's not always 8 hours. Sometimes like my body will wake up after 4 hours, right? And I'll go and I'll do some other stuff, right? I might read, go meditate a little bit. If I have an inspirational moment, I might go do some writing or some work. And then I just go back to sleep with it.
What's your morning routine? Do you have a morning routine?
Oh yeah. Every morning I will always read something and I'll always meditate. So, and it's really intentional about that. And I'll also do something that's physical, even if it's like a 20 minute walk, right? Sometimes I'll run, lift, you know, I'll go do jujitsu or something like that.
Right.
But I always make sure that I do something physical in the morning just to get the blood pumping. And I use that to replace like coffee. If I do something physical, I actually don't need stimulants to like get me jazzed up for the day with it. So, which has a nice like ancillary health benefit. But the other two pieces are what I do for my mind, right? Which is the meditation piece. To just be like, hey, can you, with everything else you got going on, Scott, my mind starts racing the moment I wake up in the morning, right? So yes. I'm like, okay, cool. So yes. Before you start going down that path, don't check email, don't log into anything, just sit and see, can you just sit for a minute and just like let the mind go blank? And then it's like you can feel everything just kind of drip, the stress just drips off you,
yes.
At least for a little while. And yes. That just, that moment of not having my mind engaged with what it is that I'm trying to create or yes. What is that, all the things I need to do is enough, even in 60 seconds, to sustain me. I'm much better if I can go longer, but I only hold myself accountable to 60 seconds of it. And then I always try to read something, at least, you know, three to five pages, but I at least commit to one page, no matter how busy I am, of whatever the book it is that I'm most interested in reading at the time. Right now, I'm reading The 4 Disciplines of Execution.
Love it.
And I find that with just being able to tap into somebody else's way of thinking for even just a brief moment into it, I start to pull those ideas into me, you know, and in a way that impacts my decision-making. But I found in ways that aren't even like intentional. Like I'll have read something the week before and I'm not like, oh, I remember that thing and that they told me to do X, Y, Z. It actually like swirls around my brain and my brain like restructures how do we need to operate given this particular scenario, right? And just a little check-in on that keeps that apparatus firing that way. Otherwise, I just fall into the old habits of how does Scott think? And I'm not really growing.
Right. I do the same, very similar. So except with the component of going to a sauna, and that's kind of the meditation time at the sauna. Because there's nothing to do in the sauna besides just sit there and just be silent. Or you could also use this for listening to something very calm, inspiring. But the sauna is great because you have 10 to 15 minutes of just downtime, if you will, and you're just sitting there. It's a great time to relax. Also, it helps decrease your chances of stress-related heart attack like by 50% if you go 3 times or more a week. So it's actually a crazy great health benefit as well. 4 Disciplines of Execution. I love it. From X to Y by Z. That's essentially the concept from four Disciplines of Execution. We actually brought in one of either the author or the co-author that taught kind of 4 Disciplines of Execution classes to our group. And it was awesome. They really talked about some great things and great principles for all business owners should consider, the spin and a bunch of other stuff that we all go through. So that's awesome. I love that you are pretty intentional on the meditation and on the reading element, on the physical element, these little things that get into those habits, you know, over long periods of time. It's the compound effect, right? It really starts to create some great things in your life. So what are you most grateful for?
Definitely my family, you know, like the family and relationships are the things to, in me that make the most difference for me of like how, what's the value, right? At the end of the day, right, I might be like a little bit more pessimistic in most of like, what are the things, like, why do I do what I do is really just based upon the fact, cause that's what I want to do. Like, I don't have like a, anything more than that. Like, oh, this is the puzzle I like. I like solving really hard problems for people and being on like solving problems better for people in ways that nobody else have been able to find anyway, does it, right? So I get off on that piece of it. Yeah. And that's what keeps me coming back to like work my, you know, 12, 14 hour days at Royal Legal, even though I don't need to. Like, I've built enough real estate to pay for all my expenses. I should just retire at 34, right? But no, I keep coming back to work like a dog to, you know, work with my team, you know, of the 30 people, and to keep going after it. But that really doesn't mean much besides the fact that, like, that's just what I enjoy. But the things that provide me meaning in my life are always my relationships and my family.
I love it. What point would you recommend hiring a coach or mentor? How important has it been in your life?
Well, I think you can actually get a lot of information for free, right? And to what it is. And I would probably, for everybody, I would start there, right? Start there. I mean, there's a lot of great ways to do it, right? And there's a lot of great ways to do it, like at really low cost, where you start to like JV in with people that are much more experienced with you. And so there's all this skin in the game that everybody's committed to it. And that a lot of times you'll find people that really want to help you learn, right? And then you can form a business relationship where they profit by helping you learn and they're engaged. Which also lets you know that they're not just there giving lip service, right, to it, which is really good. I think pretty quickly after you start having some substantial financial success, you're going to max out of what your local group is going to be able to give you, right? And then you're going to ask yourself, like, where's the next tier of people that I need to be associating with? And that's when you need to start being willing to pay that $5,000 to $25,000 a year to be able to get access to the people that are at the top of the mountain, right? I mean, the people at the top of the mountain don't really want to deal with people that are at the very bottom of the mountain, right? It's just not interesting anymore to talk, to have those conversations. So what my experience has been is that the people at the top of the mountain, they'll go hang out in groups. $5,000 to $25,000 a year doesn't actually make a big impact on their bottom line at all, but it sure does keep away everybody else that like wouldn't be at the same level they are, right? So the level of their conversations, the level of discussion that they're having, the level of their insights are much deeper when you can get behind some of those paywalls into it. So in a very real sense, you can rush into paying for access to people that really you're not going to be able to use much, right? Or you're going to use them at a really low level. But once you start feeling like I'm not really learning much new from my local group and my local connections, then that's when you need to start paying for access.
If you had to summarize it, why do you do what you do? You mentioned that you just do it because you know, like to, you make an impact. Why do you do what you do?
Well, you know, there's a lot of conversations in books that you read, like, so you got to find your why, right?
Right.
And like, when you find your big why, that's actually what gets you out of bed to work really hard, right?
Yes.
To go do it. And initially for me, that was financial freedom, time freedom, personal fulfillment. And those are all the core values of Royal Legal Solutions, right? For what are the types of investors that we're looking to help or people that share those same values and those same objectives. Now, the why peaks out because you hit the goal. And then what the hell do you do?
Right.
Because you already hit your why.
What's after? Yeah. Right.
But after that's just the puzzle. After that, you're just looking for things that keep you engaged, I think, and that keep you with fulfillment. So for me, it's this type of law firm and that runs in a new way that nobody else has really done it before, right? And the kinds of impact that you can have by doing things that are really different and how challenging that is. That becomes like its own puzzle, right? And then I find other things that I can do that allow me to have more fulfillment. Like my sister actually just turned 50 years old this year, and her whole life she's been talking about how she wanted to train teachers and help kids with dyslexia, for example, right? So it was this year, about 6 months ago, that I helped her form Brain Friendly Reading, which is a nonprofit. And all it took was coaching her like once a week for 6 weeks with her and my mom both in there, right? To get enough momentum to get them finally into schools. And within 6 months, they already have a pilot program that runs across an entire school, right? It's insane. It's like that doesn't happen with inside a school, but they're located in Detroit. It's the school that has the worst reading scores. So they went to the very bottom of the most needy people, and their solutions are amazing, but they just needed a little, they needed a little bit of cash, and they needed a little bit of accountability from somebody that could guide them through what they needed to do when only an hour a week, right? So what I'm always looking for in my life now is like ways that I can have leveraged fulfillment. I get a huge amount of fulfillment out of something that only cost me a tiny amount of time and a little bit amount of money. And I have all this impact. And Corey, you were just telling me about how you went down to go build houses for people and give them away.
Yeah.
You know, at the end of the day, we get a puzzle and we get a way that we can help other people. And there ain't nothing more to life than that. And eventually we die. And then all the stuff goes to somebody else that, you know, we'll probably waste it all in Vegas or something like that, you know, but it doesn't really matter. Right. Because the point was that we had a great life by like solving the puzzles and helping other people.
You had a great run and serving others, you know, serving others is really where fulfillment comes. You know, people think that, you know, it's the serving part comes from you're getting the fulfillment by serving somebody else, by giving your time, your resources, you know, to someone else. It is incredibly impactful. What's one way that my audience can get in touch with you, Scott? What's one way we can serve you?
Yeah. The best way, if you want to find out, the strategies that we're using for asset protection, for estate planning, for tax savings, learn more about like what it actually works to look at a real one-stop shop where you have a dedicated advisor and it's affordable, for you to do that, is just go to the royallegalsolutions.com website. Okay. We have a ton of awesome information in there that's actually broken down by the types of investors. So whether you're a single family, multifamily, or they're flipper, commercial, we put onto our website the exact strategies that we use. So you can see, you know, exactly what it is we do, how it works. You can look at it compared to like what other people look for. And if you want to have a conversation about that, the best way to do it is actually just select the take a quiz. At the very top bar of the royallegalsolutions.com website, they have an opportunity for you there to take a quiz. You answer those questions. That gives us the full profile of what we would need to know to be able to immediately start having valuable conversations with you from day one and being able to say like, hey, this is where we see that you have holes, that Scott's seen it from working with thousands of investors everywhere in the country. This is where you have holes in your game. Here's content that we can pair you with to help you with those holes. And we're going to do all of that work for you before you even give us a dollar. So that way we can just constantly be able to help people with that, knowing that this is the way that we build trust, is by being information and helpful first, and then talking about, okay, great. Well, now if you want us to build this infrastructure for you to help take off all of these things off of your plate, to have access to our network, to have all these things so you only have to focus on finding deals and you don't have to worry about anything else, you know, this is what that actually looks like. To be able to set something in there. So just go to royallegalsolutions.com, click at the take a quiz at the very top, fill that out and, you know, get that curated content for where we see where you're going to have holes in your game.
Royallegalsolutions.com. I'm going to show people right now why those that can see. So if you're hearing, you're kind of out, but you'll see here on the video and on the podcast page, you'll see right here at the top says take the quiz. Click on that and then you'll ask a couple of questions. Looks like there's a video on here as well. That's not a video. It looks like it's just embedded form. Looks like a type form. Yep. Great. This is awesome. I love it, Scott. Thank you very much for taking the time to be on here. Great, great information shared. And I got all of it here that we're going to make sure it's all in the show notes. All the links that we have, the books, we'll have links to the books. And so we'll have all that there for you. So thank you again for taking the time to be on here. I'm excited about getting to know you more and also having folks learn more about what you offer.
Awesome, Corey. Well, thank you for having me on the show. And I look forward to being able to help you and your audience any way I can.
Awesome, man. Thank you again. All right. That's it for today. Real Estate Investing Profit Masters interview, and stay tuned. We're going to bring phenomenal guests just like Scott to you on future ones.
Bye now.
Hi, this is Corey Boatwright, and I have a quick question for you. What is the fastest way to reach your goals? Is it to work harder, work smarter, use system and processes, or hire rockstar employees? What about just making more money? You know, actually, it's none of that. Those things are a byproduct of the one success component that every real estate investor or business owner that I know all have in common. And the answer is clarity. Complete laser focus on what you want, why you want it, and what are you willing to do to get it. So where do you find clarity? By hiring a coach and mentor. Now, could you reach the level of success that you want to achieve by doing this all on your own? You know, the Lone Ranger. Well, maybe, but do you think it would take you double or even triple the time to achieve it compared to hiring a coach and mentor to help guide your path, provide proven instruction with a tailored blueprint that you could follow for building a real estate business that supports your lifestyle and helps you reach your financial and personal goals? Absolutely. Here's the fact. Time isn't recyclable. So I would like to ask you to make good use of it and extend a personal invitation for you to book a phone coaching strategy session by going to callwithcorey.com. That's callwithcorey, Corey spelled C-O-R-Y.com. I'm gonna ask you a few quick questions on that page, and we're gonna go over and see how we can make sure that your business is on path to reach the goals that you want this year. So go to callwithcorey.com, that's C-O-R-Y, and book your phone coaching strategy session today. Remember, be a servant, and I'll see you on there.
You've been listening to another Real Estate Investing Profits Master Podcast Series. To receive your free real estate book, Down and Dirty, Ultimate Real Estate Investing Quick Start Guide, how to quit your job to start flipping houses in 90 days or less, head online and go to realestateinvestingprofits.com. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/realestateinvestingprofits. Thanks again for listening, and stay tuned for our next episode.